New Year's Eve. Shut up. A massive rogue wave from out of nowhere, killing the side of the ship. Her bridge instantly floods.
Thank you.
Her navigation bridge and radio room are flooded. Society can no longer move on her own power ever again. Once a passenger ship capsizes, it is unrecoverable, like what Poseidon went through. She sits upside down in the water. Her bridge is completely flooded, only her radio room. Chaos has erupted down the ship's ballroom. Upside down. After being struck by a wave, the loss of the Poseidon was inevitable that New Year's Eve. With the ship completely upside down, her propellers above the water, her rudder above the water, there was no way for her to move again. Their own power. By this point, passengers realize the whole world is up.
Yeah.
One problem, the ship does not have any bow thrusters. She's a 1930s ocean liner, for crying out loud. Once she turned over, the only way out is through the propeller shafts in the engine room at the stern of the ship. That's the only way out. The ship is completely turned over. The Coast Guard has been notified of the situation. Rescue will be underway. Then the starting, but decades earlier, White Star Line launches a new ship. Their very first new build. Oceanic. The RMS Oceanic. The very first ship for the White Star Line. Oceanic. Look at her. A brand new White Star Liner. Oceanic. Oceanic. Yeah, Oceanic. And yet, the largest ship in the White Star Line fleet by the time of her maiden voyage in 1871.